EFF leader Julius Malema will address the party's Women's Day rally in Pietermaritzburg. For more, let's cross now live to our reporter, Ayanda Mhlongo. Ayanda, very good morning to you. Happy Women's Day to you. What's happening in your neck of the woods?
Yeah, thanks very much to you, Blaine, and to Desiree. Good morning to you both and to our viewers, and thank you very much. Happy Women's Day indeed to all the women of South Africa. Very, very special and important day for women today. And of course, here in Pietermaritzburg, coming to you live from the Galuza Sports Ground in Edendale, where the economic freedom fighters are holding their Women's Day event here. And I can tell you already, if you can pass possibly see behind us, members have started arriving here in their numbers from this morning. The main address will be delivered, of course, by Sir Julius Malema. It's interesting to see, Blaine, that amongst the people that I've seen here, a lot of young people have come out here today. A lot of young women, in fact, are out here today also to send the message, to be part of today's celebration, but also some of them here saying that they're here to send a message on the challenges that women in this country are still facing. And they're eagerly awaiting to hear what their leaders are going to say and what their commitment is going to be from a leader such as Julius Malema, and what is going to be happening insofar as dealing and addressing the challenges that women of South Africa still face today. But joining me now as a woman, one of the leaders of the EFF, Sihlengiwe Khalipha, thank you so much for your time. A very, very important day for women. I was just saying that it's so interesting and good to see the young women of Pietermaritzburg have come out here to be part of today's celebrations.
Indeed, this day is very important to us, and we have chosen to come and celebrate this important day here in Gwagqaluza. Yes, indeed, we have seen that many of the people who are here, who are gathered here, is our young women. We know that in South Africa we have so many challenges, especially our young women are killed, are raped, are beaten up, especially by people who are supposed to love them, who are supposed to care and protect them. So I'm sure the reason why they are here today is to come to celebrate with the EFF, because EFF is the only political party that resonates with young people in South Africa. When there is a challenge, EFF just zoom in and solve those challenges. So we are here to celebrate that day today, and we are expecting our Commander-in-Chief to come and talk to us about this important day, because we remember that in 1956, our women stood up and say no against pass of laws in South Africa. But today's challenges is different from those challenges, because we are under democratical dispensation. But we see poverty, we see unemployment, we see those abuse that are still taking place in South Africa. So we are saying as EFF, enough is enough. Let us stand up and fight against the scourge of abuse of women.
So Sihlengiwe, you are in Parliament. The public, these women who are out here today, are relying on yourself, particularly as women, to go there and make changes to our laws, make changes to government, what will in fact end up protecting women and giving women the recognition that they deserve.
Indeed, let us start by saying that political parties who send people in Parliament, they are not serious about this gender equality. It's the only EFF, because out of 25 members of Parliament of EFF, 50% of those 25 MPs are women. As a young political parties who are 5 years old, we made sure that even if we go and elect our structures, we address the gender balance, the challenges. Then coming back to Parliament, you know that the Speaker of Parliament is a woman, but the very same Speaker who's a woman hired bouncers to come and beat us up as women. I'm talking about women who lost their babies because of the decision of a woman in leadership in the ANC. So there is a bigger challenge. Coming back to the Cyril Ramaphosa, who took that decision of replacing the previous minister to head the presidency in women and put a very useless person, but Thabile Dlamini. So, I mean, those people, they don't take us serious. So it means that even if you go to Parliament to try and change laws, there is a problem, because the person who's supposed to be championing the gender balance issues, they are not taking those issues forward. But as EFF, we are pushing, because when you go to our manifesto, we talk about the championing of women issues. So we are promising South Africa that we are going to fight on their behalf as EFF.
Speaking about the promises, what is it, if you can specifically tell us, does the EFF plan to prioritize when it comes to dealing with the matters around women?
So we are dealing with all matters now, because each and every day EFF got calls from different spheres of society, especially the abuse of women. We intervene. We go and sit down to say what happened. No, there's a problem at work. I'm being victimized. You remember there was an issue here in KZN whereby a young woman poor patrol by an employer in Durban. So we have zoomed in. We protected that woman. We helped that woman to go and open a case. And then we just go and make a follow-up as well to say, Minister of Police, what are you doing? Because this is a young woman who can't even go to work because of what happened. So, I mean, we are coordinating all issues that come to our attentions as EFF.
Thank you so much for your time there. Thank you, Mkalipi, the National Deputy Secretary of the EFF. She's amongst the leaders of the EFF who have come out here today to celebrate this Women's Day, and of course saying some of the concerns that they have as a party, but also saying what plans they have and what they're doing, as she said, on a daily basis to try and assist the women of South Africa. But I must say, as I said earlier on their plane, very good to see and lovely to see the young women who have come out here today. Some are saying that yes, we are challenges, but also today is a day where we celebrate women, to celebrate the achievements of women who, some under a very difficult circumstances, have been able to move above them. Women are doing incredible things in society, in their homes, in their communities, in their business. And some of the ladies that are out here today, the women who are out here today, saying it's also a day where we need to celebrate these achievements, giant strides that the women of South Africa are making. And also equally just seeing some of the young men who are out here as well today to support the women, to say they too are going to be taking a stand against the abuse of women, and who also acknowledge that indeed they are thankful to the work that the women do in this country, and that it's important that they continue to support the women of South Africa. So the program, as I've said, Julius Malema is expected to deliver that key note address, and some of the leaders of the EFF are already here, both national and provincial. More people are expected to arrive, and proceedings are expected to possibly get underway here within the next hour. Play.
Ayanda, thank you very much indeed for your reporting. Ayanda Mhlongo, live in Pietermaritzburg, where the economic freedom fighters are celebrating Women's Day.